Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming channel. So we got huge update yesterday. The new chapter 6, new skin, new event, and also new banner. Yeah, we got this Delacey and Evelyn banner. Okay, I will talk about the new banner and also the new chapter 6 in this video, especially the hardest part of the chapter 6. Because yeah, that one has a really tough boss. But before that, I want to say thank you to BlueStack for sponsoring this video. As you can see here, I'm using BlueStack to record this video. And if you want to play in the bigger screen, you want to play in the PC, I would recommend you guys to use BlueStack. Use the link on the description below to install NeuralCloud in BlueStack to support this channel, because every time you install NeuralCloud using that link, I will get paid by them, basically. And if you want to do reroll, if you are kind of planning to start the game after you watch this video, please use that link to install NeuralCloud in your BlueStack and do reroll in BlueStack. Multiple BlueStacks, and yeah, you can basically use the synchronize function to finish the tutorial all at once, and that's going to be time saver. Okay, so about this Delacey, basically she is a single target healer that can only heal the character that has the highest attack or hash rate, and it will also boost the attack or hash rate of that character by 40%, so a really good attack buffer for your DPS. And the second skill will give her super armor while dealing opponent damage equal to 100% of hash rate to all enemies in contact with the primary tether every 1 second for 6 seconds. And yeah, it will also boost the healing effect of the first skill, which is a passive skill. Yeah, basically she is a single target dedicated healer for your DPS, and also a buffer, which is basically you cannot use her alone as the only healer in your party. So yeah, if you are an F2P, I will say totally skip this banner. Do not waste your core sense in this banner. But somehow, if you are those people that are willing to spend real money to buy quartz, it is actually quite okay to get her, because she's actually like a good dedicated healer and buffer for your DPS. You can imagine if you have Hatsuchiri, and then Hatsuchiri getting buffed by Delacey, getting 40% attack boost, that's going to be really something. Yeah, because the only one that can do that kind of thing is Delacey. Yeah, but if you are F2P, this one is totally skippable. Personally, I won't pull in this banner using my current account. But there is a possibility that I will create a new account just to get her. The next update is the new chapter 6, right? It is here on the event, guys. And in this event, we have this ocean exploration, which is kind of like the special stage. If we clear this, basically we will get this data repair. Yeah, the missing data. This will refresh daily, and we can only enter this like twice, if I'm not wrong. So clear the highest stage you can get. And yeah, since the event is still quite long, I think in the end you will be able to claim all of these. Good event, I think. And on the main story, there are two modes: standard mode and hard mode. Actually, yesterday I really thought that the standard mode is the actual standard mode that we usually get on the previous stages, so I did the standard mode until this part, and then I read this, the event description. Actually, if you clear the hard mode, you will be able to get both standard and hard modes first clear reward. So basically, if you able to do the hard mode, just do the hard mode. You can totally skip the standard mode. Yeah, but if you are new to the game and if you don't have high power yet, somehow you cannot clear the hard mode, you can clear the standard mode, because they have like around half lower recommended power than the hard mode. So yeah, much easier to clear, and at least you can get the first clear rewards by clearing all of the standard mode if you are a new player. And yeah, as I mentioned before on the previous video about how relevant Kuro is, the stage 626 is actually the most difficult stage on the chapter 6. They are all very easy to do until this part. Well, if you don't have enough power, you can use that Nakama power, bring a strong friend to clear the stage. So in this video, I will do the walkthrough for this 626, because this one has an insanely tough boss. I will use my own party because my own party have enough recommended power, 44k. If somehow you don't have a strong Kuro in your account, like you don't have 5-star Kuro with more than 9000 power, I would recommend you guys to pick a Kuro friend that has more than 9000 power. There are a lot of them, so I think it's quite easy to find a strong Kuro friend because you are going to need a seriously strong single target DPS for this stage. And yeah, for the other DPS, you can use Hubble or any other hash rate DPS because yeah, I will definitely going to maximize the hash rate for my Kuro. Okay, so let's just start it. Basically here, you can see the function cards drop. This one will drop Specialist, Specialist, Warrior, and this one is ranged. So I think I'm just going to do this one because I want to get the function cards for my Kuro basically. And for this overdrive tile, I would recommend you guys put your strongest DPS here because right from the beginning, my Kuro will be able to use the skill. Yeah. Okay, but it got cancelled by the wave just now. You can also put Hubble in that part because Hubble will do a decent AoE damage using her skill. Kuro is single target. About the buffs, this one is actually quite good, by the way. Yeah, this one is okay to get, in my opinion. Sigils, normal attack are guaranteed to crit and drill an extra 30% lifesteal. One stack of this buff is consumed every time the effect is triggered. So with this function card, actually our range character, which is Kuro and Hubble, will also do critical and get lifesteal effect, which is nice. And I would recommend you guys to get this kind of function card set because this one is good. It will boost the hash rate of the healed characters, including our DPS. Yeah, this is the one that I mentioned. When medic heals, they increase the hash rate of ally units and themselves by 5% for 6 seconds, up to 5 seconds. Yeah, it means 25% hash rate boost just from this. Very good for Kuro. I will get this one. This one is good. And this one is highly recommended, guys. The anger feedback. Ally units have their auto skill recharge sped up by 5% after landing critical hit with normal attack. This one is good, up to 15%. Actually, this set is probably not really needed for Kuro, but the effect is actually nice, attack speed 50, so let's just get this one. As for the normal enemies, I think they are quite easy to do it with full auto like this. You don't really need to use any ultimate. Yeah, just save your ultimate for the last boss. And on the recovery area, I would recommend to enter the trading area. Try to get the protocols. Yeah, this one is good. Basically, you will need to boost Kuro's damage as high as possible. I will get this one. This is really good, by the way. Ally long-range unit deal 50% more damage, but their HP is reduced by 50%. Okay, this set is actually quite good. So let's get this. One. Two. So, okay, let's fight the first boss with this. Okay, hopefully strong enough with only one good protocol. Because this boss is seriously annoying. Let's use Kuro's ultimate here. Okay, so every time the boss use the destruction lash, basically it will prevent us to damage the boss and the boss will summon a lot of minions, and after that the boss will recover some HP basically. But okay, this one didn't recover HP. If your damage is not good enough, basically the boss will recover HP like crazy, and that's going to be really troublesome. I need this, hash rate plus 50% and attack minus 50% for all non-healer ally dolls. Okay, here we go, brainstorm. Yep, this will boost Kuro's damage even higher. I think with this, we can already beat the boss like quite easily, but okay, let's try to get some more buffs. This one will be good, okay. Let's go with these buffs. Yeah, all of these three protocols are the one we need. Sharpshooter, heavy power, and brainstorm. I think with this, we can already beat the boss quite easily. Okay, let's use Hubble's ultimate. Okay, we need to destroy this. what is his name? The Rock, that can make the waves and stun our characters. Okay, let's destroy it with Kuro's ultimate. Okay, no more waves. Oh, okay, the boss died. So yeah, if you pick the correct buffs, somehow the boss will become quite easy. Okay, let's fight a stronger version of it. Basically, if you have enough damage, this boss will be very easy. If you didn't get any of these protocols that I mentioned and also these function cards that I mentioned in this video, if you do it only with full auto, you will realize that this boss is ridiculously hard. So this one is more difficult than the previous one. Let's do this. Let's kill the wave maker. Apple's ultimate to clear these small ones. Okay, focus target the boss. Alright. Yeah, sometimes the boss can recover HP, and that's really annoying if you don't have enough damage for this. Okay, my Hubble died. Luckily, my Kuro didn't. So yeah, this is how to beat this boss. If you have the correct buff, and if you bring the correct character, this boss is quite easy to beat, as you can see in this video. After I clear the chapter 628, basically I will be able to unlock the potential breakthrough for level 70. So good luck for clearing the chapter 6, and let's wait for Hatsuchiri next week. So thank you for watching, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and see you next time. Bye, Ushi Punch.